Gattaca Movie Recap. This is Lavender Recap. In today's video, we will be going through an American dystopian science fiction thriller from 1997 titled Gattaca. Jerome is about to embark on a one-year manned mission to Titan, 14th moon of Saturn. Not an easy assignment, but Jerome knows he was genetically made for this. We see that a baby was conceived and born in the so-called Detroit Riviera. Right after his birth, they draw some blood from the baby's heel to run some tests. The nurse sums up all the genetic disorders he has and says the baby's life expectancy is 30.2 years, which makes his father visibly anxious. The mother wants to call the baby Anton, but his dad decides it should be Vincent Anton. Vincent's parents decide to get him a brother to play with, which turns out to be Anton. Vincent's brother isn't born with a genetic disorder and his father considers him worthy of his name, Anton. As they grow up, Vincent always aspired to travel to space, while Anton enjoys receiving praise from his family. Vincent and Anton always played a child game called Chicken. The game Chicken was about the one who gets scared first and wants to go back while swimming in open water. Vincent was always the one to get tired and turn away first. He was literally considered the chicken, while Anton was considered the greatest swimmer. One day, Vincent and Anton played the game Chicken. Anton asks if Vincent really wants to do this again, and then they both start swimming. Suddenly, Anton drowns in the water and he calls for Vincent's help. Vincent swims back towards Anton and he rescues him. Vincent begins to realize that his brother Anton isn't as strong as he believed, and he himself is not as weak as he thought he was. That moment was the turning point, and Vincent now believes that everything is possible for him. In the evening, Vincent walks out of the house without saying anything and he leaves the place where he was considered weak. Once he had left his parental house, Vincent moved around a lot and did work wherever he could. He started doing a cleaning job, saying he must have cleaned at least half the toilets in all the states. Vincent realizes that there is no longer discrimination based on the color of your skin, but based on your DNA due to science. They arrive at Gattaca Aerospace to clean the building. While being there, he'd never been closer to realizing his dream. Nonetheless, he had never felt further away from it than he did right then. While he is cleaning the floor, he stops to take a seat behind the desk and starts daydreaming about what it would be like to work there. Back home, he continued his efforts, intensive training and intensive study. But he also realized that his efforts would never be sufficient as his blood test would surely always fail the system. Vincent meets a so-called DNA broker, a person who specializes in helping invalids assume an identity of a valid person who, for whatever reason, is unable to live a perfect life. The DNA broker asks if Vincent is 100% sure about it, and when Vincent confirms, he shows him the DNA of someone he has in mind. Vincent's arrangement with the DNA broker is called a borrowed ladder. The broker takes Vincent to meet Jerome Eugene Morrow. His credentials were impeccable, just as his expiration date. Eugene was considered to be Vincent's borrowed ladder. The broker goes on and says that Jerome Eugene is a former athlete who was paralyzed in an accident and is now confined to a wheelchair. He used to be an excellent athlete who had won silver medals at the World Championships. His entire genetic code was flawless. Eugene was genetically determined for glory with superb genetic gifts such as a heart of an ox and an IQ of the register. Vincent goes through a series of treatments to match Eugene's height, hair color, eyesight, and color, and dental health for whichever the broker asks in return 25% of all profit they make. After all the treatments, Vincent was armed with Eugene's genetics and used Jerome Eugene as his new identity. Vincent, still pursuing his dream, secures a job at Gattaca using Eugene's genetics. Vincent no longer has to clean the office windows, but is now a prospective navigator officer for a deep space mission to Saturn's moon Titan. In order to maintain the borrowed ladder rules, Vincent must scrub and scrape his skin daily in a blue room to remove all the loose material remaining to limit how much of his invalid cells he would leave in the valid world. Eugene, on the other hand, prepared as much blood, urine, and hair as possible to provide Vincent with valid cells he could use. Vincent carries around a blood and urine sachet filled with Eugene's blood and urine and has to inject it into his fingertips to pass the daily substance screening. Vincent even vacuums his workstation and plants a skin flake in his keyboard and hair in his comb. A week before Vincent departs for his mission, one of the managers is brutally murdered in his office with a keyboard. The law enforcement officers used a fine-tooth comb to go through the entire company and found one of Vincent's eyelashes. After a quick examination, they discovered that it belonged to a man who had previously worked as a cleaner for the company but had vanished years before. The mysterious man was the prime suspect, and his image was displayed all over the place. However, no one associated it with the wrong Eugene, no one but the lieutenant, who happened to be his brother, Anton. That was difficult for him to believe. This brother, who had always been inferior to him, had risen through the ranks and become a murderer. He initially attempted to shield him. Vincent knew he needed to avoid detection for 7 days so he could safely get out to complete his Titan mission. During this period, Irene Cassani appears. Irene is Vincent's co-worker and rival who later becomes his love. Along the line, Irene got serious with Vincent and confessed to him that she was his rival, and as a result, she had his DNA sampled using the hair he planted on his comb. Irene, who thought Vincent was truly Eugene, began to fall for him, and vice versa. Irene informed Vincent that she might not go to space because she was diagnosed to have heart disease, which would affect her greatly in the near future. Irene gives a strand of her hair to Vincent so he can scan it. Vincent gives it back and lets her know that he is attracted to her personality and not her genes. Vincent and Irene are seen at a dinner party where some investigators came in to do some investigations. Vincent gets nearly exposed when a cup of his own DNA is found in the trash can. Both employees were urged to get tested using a blood test sample because the investigators were beginning to believe there is a borrowed ladder in Gattaca. Vincent gets tested in his veins and pretends that Dr. Lamar accidentally hurt him while drawing blood from him. But he was smart enough to switch his invalid blood sample with Eugene's valid blood sample and once again passed the screening. On another date, the evening gets interrupted by investigators, including Anton, while they are dancing and they manage to get out through the back door. As an officer was standing behind the back door, Vincent had to knock him out. He and Irene are running through a small street when Irene falls and Vincent pulls her into an alley. The police screamed his real name, which made Irene confused. Vincent had to reveal part of the truth to Irene. The truth led to the duo spending the night together. Irene notices his injury and asks how he got it. The lead investigator, Anton, is now very convinced that Vincent has a borrowed ladder and wants to test him again. Anton and an administrator were seen discussing in the office. Irene entered the office and heard what they discussed. She quickly left the office without being noticed and headed to tell Vincent to go home because she noticed he looked pale and was not feeling too well. Vincent realized what Irene meant and understood that the investigator was going to his house to get him tested. Vincent called Eugene to inform him about the investigator and asked him to act like himself all through his meeting with him so they don't suspect him. On hearing the news, Eugene casts himself out of his wheelchair and drags himself uncomfortably up the stairs to answer the door buzzer. He places himself in the wheelchair and received his visitors gently so as not to get caught. Anton and Irene stand in front of the door and ring the bell. As they walk in, Irene is shocked to see the real Eugene instead of Vincent. And Eugene asks Irene, "Where is my kiss?" This is not what Anton expected when he tests Eugene's blood and finds out that it is valid, which means Vincent is truly who he says he is. The detective wanted to search the house before he got a call from Detective Hugo that the real criminal has been found. As the detective leaves, Vincent comes up from downstairs. Irene is looking confused and leaves the place while she is obviously pissed. Vincent ran after her and she tells Vincent, "Don't even dare to touch me," because she has no idea who he really is. Vincent responds that he is the same person he was yesterday when they were always together. Vincent tells Irene about his heart defect and that he already lived longer than his expiration date. He makes her realize that they are not as weak as people think they are, and they can be more than what people think they are when you're not focused on the things that are wrong. Anton and Detective Hugo meet at Gattaca to find out that it was Josef that murdered the administrator. Josef said that he murdered him because the administrator was threatening to cancel the Titan mission, and he knew that if it got canceled, there wouldn't be any other opportunity in his lifetime. Back in the house, Vincent asks Eugene the name of the detective, what the detective looks like, and what he said to him. Vincent knew it won't be over until he faces Anton himself. Vincent travels back to Gattaca to confront Anton. He meets the detective at the workstation and reveals himself to Anton. The two have a heated argument over Vincent's rights to be in Gattaca. Anton tells Vincent to stop fraud and offers to help him get out of trouble. Vincent is not willing to cooperate and asks Anton if he has any idea how much he suffered to even get to Gattaca. During the heated argument, Vincent reminds Anton that he does not need help. Anton was the one who needed his help once. Anton challenges Vincent to play the chicken game again. Vincent accepted the challenge, and both brothers are taking their clothes off in the middle of the night to start their challenge. As the challenge got halfway, Anton stops and tells Vincent they should go back as they can't see the shore anymore and they won't have energy to make it back. Vincent asks him if he really wants to go back and continue swimming. Then, Anton stops again and asks how Vincent achieved all this and how he made it to Gattaca. Vincent tells him the metaphor that he made it this far because he never saved something for the way back. He saved his brother again. Vincent is talking with Irene, and Vincent picks his hair strand and hands it over to Irene. He tells her to get back to him if she is still interested in him. Irene hands the hair back to him and tells him that she accepts him for who he is, and not for who the world wants him to be. The day of the launch finally came, and Eugene showed Vincent enough genetic material that he can use through his lifetime and screening process. Eugene also gave him a letter and instructed him to keep it until he gets to space. Vincent arrives at Gattaca and was uncomfortably surprised to see that they had to do one more urine test before they could enter the spaceship. Vincent lamented because he knew he didn't hold any extra urine sachet material and he knew he would be discovered. Vincent was tested by Dr. Lamar, who knew all along about the fact that he was invalid. Dr. Lamar changed Vincent's status to valid himself because he had a son who was also genetically inferior and had the same dream as Vincent. Dr. Lamar tells Vincent that his son was a fan of his and also wants to apply at Gattaca. Dr. Lamar tells Vincent to go quickly into the rocket, not to miss his flight. As Vincent enters into the rocket, the camera brings itself to the incinerator in Eugene's space where Vincent usually scrubs and destroys his loose skin and hair. The flames coming out of the incinerator, and Eugene has committed suicide in there. It is believed that Eugene seems to have completed his assignment by fulfilling Vincent's dream. The scene also shows Eugene's silver medal as a symbol of his personal failure. Eugene's life ended on a tragic note, while Vincent's life just began in space. Finally, Vincent opens the letter and finds a piece of Eugene's hair. That's the end of today's movie recap. What do you think is the message of this movie? If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're new to the channel to be notified when we upload more content.